The only truth to the article was that I'm impatient. You know, I am impatient. I mean, this nation is going bankrupt, and so, you know, I haven't gone to Washington to just sit back. Well, again, they're grossly false, and there's really no truth to them at all, and it's unfortunate. I mean, it's a hit piece. I guess, you know, the only truth to the article was that I'm impatient. You know, I am impatient. I mean, this nation is going bankrupt, and so, you know, I haven't gone to Washington to just sit back, you know, and kind of look at what's happening. I went there to actually fight, really for the preservation of this nation, fight for Wisconsin.
Well, that's a perfect transition question, because you mentioned in your speech to the Young America's Foundation today that Congressman Ryan's budget cuts about over 10 years, you know, $7 trillion compared to President Obama's, but that's relatively...
No, again, reduces the rate of growth.
It reduces the rate of
growth. Don't get trapped in that. I mean,
well,
because we're not cutting anything. We're just reducing the rate of growth in government.
Well, and you're going directly to my point. Is what Congressman Ryan doing anywhere close to enough for young people and to save our future?
Nobody can really answer that question. It's a serious budget. I mean, it's a serious budget. It's a real proposal. It lays out something, you know, it addresses probably the longest or the largest problem we have, which is Medicare. It does that, I think, in a responsible way. You know, you can quibble in terms of how quickly. We were speaking earlier, Congressman Ryan is constrained by having to utilize CBO growth figures that assume the taxes are increasing, but he's not putting tax increases in his budget. So his budget is actually more responsible, and it would actually lower the deficit faster than what the CBO will score it. You've heard that political debate for years in Washington. There's all kinds of people who'd like to reduce the rate of growth and spending faster. I would certainly be one of those, but I'm not going to sit here and criticize Paul Ryan for actually putting forward a plan and being serious about it. It might be enough. I mean, nobody can really tell. What it does do, and this is important, it recognizes the most important metric really is our debt-to-GDP ratio. And even with unfair CBO scoring, it stabilizes that ratio and starts bringing it down. And I think if we can do that, I think we'll be okay as a nation.
Why is it so important that young people get involved? And what can they really do personally to help save the country?
Well, first of all, it's their future that's being mortgaged right now. And it's grotesquely unfair. And we are, as you mentioned, we are committing intergenerational theft. And it is immoral. It's wrong. It has to stop. It is the hearts and minds of our youth that is most important. I mean, it sounds like a tired old political phrase, but the fact of the matter is the youth is our future, and it is their future that's being mortgaged.